Big Monster Laboratory here. Today we'll take a quick look at a beginner Arduino project and see how to make some adjustable speed chasing LEDs. You may have seen this from one of my previous YouTube Shorts videos. Every once in a while somebody will say, hey, what's the code for this, or how do you put this together? So that everyone benefits, let's just go ahead and make a quick video to see how it's done. Let's get started. Well, this project doesn't take many components, and it is an excellent place for anybody beginning with Arduino to begin. So what you'll need is a breadboard. You'll need some 5mm LEDs. I went with the blue. You can use whatever color you want. You'll need some melt-to-melt jumper wires. You'll need a 5K potentiometer. If you don't have 5K, you have 4K, that's fine. If you have 8K, that'd probably work too. And you'll need an Arduino board. You can use Uno or Mega. I'm using the Mega board. Now, to power your Arduino, you can do it several different ways. You can use a 9-volt battery. You stick the positive lead in the VIN pin and the black lead into the ground pin of your board. You can also use a breadboard power supply. I am really fond of that. Or you can use a DC power connector that comes straight from a plug and allows you to use two leads, a positive and negative, to plug right into your breadboard and ultimately power your Arduino board as well. Now, powering it with your 9-volt battery is convenient for portability, but the battery will die. If you use the breadboard power supply or the DC power connector, you don't have to worry about your battery dying, so those are two great options as well. Now, first off, you're going to need your breadboard. Then you're going to need your Arduino Mega. Now it's time to put your 5mm LEDs and your 5K potentiometer into your breadboard. Next, you're going to connect your 220 ohm resistors to the negative pin of your LEDs and to the negative rail of your breadboard. Next, you're going to connect the positive pin of your LED to pins 2 through 13 on your Elegoo or Arduino Mega board. Next, you want to connect your potentiometer, so the left pin of a potentiometer will connect to the 5-volt pin of your board. The middle pin will connect to an analog pin of your board. I'm choosing analog 0. And then your right pin of the potentiometer will connect to the negative rail of your breadboard. Then I connect the negative rail of the breadboard to the ground pin on the Elegoo Mega board to tie it all together. The code for this project is pretty short. The first thing you want to do is include all of your pins in the array up here, all your LEDs from pin 2 to 13. We also want to include a small delay between changes in the LED. And then down here, don't forget to include your potentiometer that we put at analog 0. Now down here in the setup, we're going to include all of our pins as an output. So down here in the loop, we're going to read the value of our potentiometer. And down here, we're going to turn the LED on, and it is going to incrementally change in the direction of the value. And then we include both positive and negative so they can go both directions. And that is the code for this project. And so now after you set it up, all you have to do to make it speed up and slow down is turn the potentiometer either clockwise or counterclockwise. And you'll have fun with this one, I think. That's all I have for now. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure you subscribe. And click the bell notification as well. And I will see you again very soon. Thank you for watching.